Ganesh Pine, one of the most outstanding painters of the post-1950s generation of artists, was born in the then Calcutta, now Kolkata, in 1937. In the mid-1950s, he joined the Government Art College in Calcutta. In the early 1950s, Pine saw a retrospective of Abanindranath Tagore's works, and it left a lasting impression on him. He describes Abanindranath's paintings as intimate soliloquies. He sought to reflect the same intimacy in his work. After graduating from art college in 1957, Pine could not secure any regular job. He earned money by illustrating books. It is a practice he carried on even after he was a well-established artist. In 1962, Pine was taken as a part-time illustrator at Mandar Malik's studio for animated films. It is located in a crumbling mansion in Cornwallis Street in Calcutta. The assignment and location played an important role in his art. It was from this time onwards that Pine started evolving his own distinctive language. The lyricism and the figuration of the early years yielded place to razor-sharp lines cutting through blank space on the paper with angst and intensity. Also, Pine began to introduce expressionist distortion in his figures. He added skeletal elements to the figure to suggest intimations of mortality. He began to experiment with texturization, and he evoked beautifully the crumbling surfaces of a decaying city. Both the figuration and the texturization became his imprimatur, as did his use of shadows and light in his picture space. In this show, one can see his drawings, watercolors, mixed media, and a tempera. A new genre of exhibits seen here is the painting with images on letters that he wrote to his friend Shaibal Ghosh. Some of the images in this collection were later transformed into full-fledged temperas or mixed medias. Pine had a series of favorite images which were not just fantastic forms, but were symbolic of his experiences and his state of mind. Many of his favorite tropes are seen at this exhibition. There is the deserted, dilapidated building with the interior like a dark abyss. There are the performing monkeys. There is a very interesting watercolor of a seated woman and a cat, with a touch of irony. And then, of course, there is a tempera, which is Pine's very own special medium. It is called Woman Sewing. It shows a woman as a nurturer. She is carrying a sapling, a symbol of hope.